Hey guys, what's going on? Liam here. Bit of a setback today. I did go out and film a whole like 25 minute video outside while I was grounding it in the sunlight, but the audio was completely horrendous, so I'm not going to use that to basically spare you guys your ears. It was just keep going and popping every 5 seconds. It was terrible. So I'm going to break down now what to do if you live in a country that doesn't have sunlight. Now, before I do that, just to reiterate how important sunlight is, I'm going to show you an audio clip by Jack Cruz. So Dr. Jack Cruz, okay, is a neuroscientist and a quantum biologist. He talks about the same sort of stuff I do. He's obviously a lot smarter than me. He's a lot more educated than me. So when he talks about this stuff, he uses the actual science and he explains the physics behind it, okay? He puts it very, very technically. Now, when I explain the same stuff, I use metaphors and analogies and just simplify the shit out of it. Now, that's because, obviously, this is not a science class, it's not a biology class. You just want to know, okay, well, okay, I understand that it works, Liam, but what's, like, the basic idea? Like, well, what's the basic behind it? Just so I have something to hold on to, just so I can, you know, use it. So that's what my YouTube channel is about. I'll give you the basic breakdown. So right now, I'm going to show you an audio of Dr. Jack Cruz talking about what I always talk about, which is that you need sunlight, okay, and you need food to charge your electrons, and it ties in with your endoplasmic reticulum, okay, to transform, okay, the vibrations of the air, okay, in your cochlea, okay, which is where the mitochondria in the cells exist, okay, into electricity so your brain can process it as hearing. If you don't have enough power, you know, jazzed up electrons from sunlight, you need 2/3 of the electrons are powered by sunlight, okay, 1/3 by food. You need twice as much sun as you do nutrition. You need animal products and nutrition, and you need sun, okay? So here's audio.
But here's where it gets really interesting. Food only provides 1/3 of the amount of electrons to make ATP. Well, guess what is supposed to provide the other 2/3? Sunlight. And how does that happen? It's a function of a protein on the inner mitochondrial membrane called cytochrome C oxidase, which I think most people know. And cytochrome C oxidase is a heme protein, just like hemoglobin in our skin. And what it does, it absorbs best in what we call the optical window. And the optical window goes from about 700 nanometers to 1400 nanometers, specifically in the red and near infrared range. And what does it do? It makes the ATPase spin much faster. And we create several things from that. Not only do we create ATP, we create the other 2/3 of the ATP that food don't provide us.
Okay, so a little bit dense, which is why I try to keep it, you know, because I realize that if I start talking really technically, people are going to get turned off and go, oh, well, this is just, it's too hard for me to do, and put it by the wayside and never get back to it. And then they might, you know, capitulation, and live a terrible life. Whereas, you know, if I just kept it simple, they could have just, you know, gotten rid of their tinnitus, or at least, you know, had the best chance of getting rid of their tinnitus. I'm not pretending that I have a cure-all for everyone. That's not what this is, okay? But it works bloody damn well for so, so many people. Why not give it a go? So anyway, let's get into what to do if you don't live in a sunny country. So if you live in, let's say, somewhere like the UK or Ireland or Wales, where it's really, really, you know, terrible all year round and it's pretty dreary and there's barely any sun, or you live in somewhere like Sweden or Australia, where I'm from, Australia, not Sweden, I wish, but the girls are fantastic. But the point is, you're going to have sun some of the year, and, you know, you're going to have darkness, you know, and pretty dreariness for the rest of the year. And in Australia, it could be sunny in the morning and hailing in the afternoon. That's the way it works over there. So what to do if you live in the UK or Wales or somewhere it's just completely terrible? What we want to do is optimize your time in the sun. And I'm not just talking about length. So the basic things like take your clothes off, get as much sun as you can for as long as you can, as long as you're doing it incrementally. Don't just go blasting out into the sun and get burnt. What we want to do is you got to understand how a cell catches light. So cells, okay, the outer ring of the cells, uses structured water, okay, to catch the light. The structured water acts as a sort of catcher's mitt, okay? And where does that water come from? The mitochondria makes it. And what helps mitochondria function, okay? Electrons. So it's kind of like a self-fulfilling prophecy. You get sunlight, it makes structured water. Go figure, right? It obviously draws water from your cells. Okay, can make it from a multitude of things. That's very complex stuff. Look up Jack Cruz if you want to see that. But I'm just going to teach you how to use this. Okay, so what dehydrates that water? Apart from, obviously, if you take halides, it'll strip the electrons from your mitochondria and you'll have a problem there and your cells will die, blah, blah, blah. So what can you do, or what are you doing right now that you might not realize is dehydrating the structured water around the outside of your cell, which is supposed to be catching sunlight and charging your electrons? One of the main things people do is they expose themselves to high levels, and very often high levels, of non-native EMF. So that could be things like microwaves, put your computer on your lap, okay? Wi-Fi, but mostly blue light, okay? If you're putting blue light into your skin, remember, your skin, okay, takes in light, okay? It takes in light to power the electrons, okay? In your skin, you do it in your ears. You have light receptors inside your ear, okay? Inside the actual inner ear, inside the cochlea, you have melanopsin, okay? And melanin. So you have melanin, the hormone melanin, it takes in light and releases melanocytes. You actually have light receptors inside your ears. Your ears need light to function. It is as simple as that. They need twice as much sunlight as they do food to function. It's very, very interesting. So obviously you're going to spend as much time as you can out in the sun without burning yourself. But as I just said, cut out the dehydrating agents. Cut out the positively charged ions from the Wi-Fi, from the phone in your pocket, from talking on the phone, from using headphones, okay? Don't use headphones. That's just fucking ridiculous. I do still use headphones sometimes because I enjoy it, but I always use personally the in-ear ones. That's just the ones so I can cut out the outside noise so I don't turn up too loud. If you have low-quality headphones, then you're going to try and drown out the outside noise. Have you ever had that situation where you'll be on a train or something with headphones listening to music and you'll turn it up to drown out the train? And you get off the train and go, God, that was loud. Like, because you're in a quiet environment, God, that was loud. That just shows how much you're hurting your ears. So you can get noise-canceling headphones, whatever, but, you know, the less electronic function near your ears, the better, or your body, the function. The next thing is obviously sodium salicylates. Sodium salicylates come under the group of photosynthesizers. You can look up what they are. Sodium salicylate also exists in non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. And I'm sure a lot of you get given that straight away by a doctor at ENT to try and fix tinnitus in the first place. Now hopefully you see how fucking stupid that is and it makes no sense whatsoever, okay? And antidepressants too, which strip the halides. Antidepressants, the halides in that, in medications, strip electrons from the mitochondria, okay, inside your ears, which is supposed to be used to help you hear. Where the fuck is the logic in that? How does that make any sort of sense? Like, give me a break. Jack Cruz actually as well talks about tinnitus, and he talks about how ENTs and people with vision problems, visual snow, and people with hearing problems, they often go to their ENTs and say, well, you know, we don't know what do I do? And ENT's like, I don't know. I've got no idea. Now, I don't agree with everything that Jack Cruz says. He's very handy and heavy on the vegetables, which I don't think makes, you know, much sense. But he is a, you know, quantum biologist, so I'm not going to sit and pretend that I know more about him. But I just find that people with tinnitus, when they cut out the vegetables, they get much, much, much better results. And that's what we care about here, isn't it? The results. So anyway, as I was saying, cut the sodium salicylates because they will actually cause your capacity to take in light particles, okay, from the sun, they will inhibit that ability. So then you're getting less sun. Also, you'll get burnt. I found myself personally in Bali when I was there. Let me show this is still recording. When I was in Bali, okay, there would be a beach and I'd be sitting on the deck chair on the sand with my feet over the sides, grounding on the ground, and I'd go for a swim on the sand. And I was the only person that eventually I walked up to the beach every morning because I was always in the sun for the sunrise, okay? And the staff there would know, okay, he's coming, take the umbrella down, the big massive umbrella. I was the only person who wanted to be in the sun all day long, okay? I was in the sun probably 4 hours a day, 5 days a week in Bali, okay? And I never got burnt. I barely got browned. And you'll see this all the time. People say, I cut out vegetables and I cut out, you know, fruits and all this sort of stuff. And it's really weird. I don't get burnt anymore. It's the lack of sodium salicylates in your diet. So that's going to help you stay out in the sun for longer. Cutting out the non-native EMFs such as Wi-Fi and blue light is going to make sure that you actually take in the sun. Also, you want to get the sunrise and the sunset. Now, you saw some footage from my window and you saw some footage from the hallway window there of the sunrise and all that sort of stuff. Why do you want to even get the sunrise and the sunset? The first thing is if you're up early for the sunrise, you're going to be tired at night. It's going to be easier to sleep. That's a benefit that everybody with tinnitus wants. The second thing is you want to set your melatonin and cortisol cycle. And that's done by, multiple things. Light, temperature, okay, social interaction. Very, very interesting. It's done by a whole bunch of things. The easiest way to do it is to get up early for the sunrise and be outside for the sunset. Now, maybe, you know, if you're in Sweden and it's like, what is it, dark, like almost every day, part of the winter, or it's just constantly sunny all day, then yeah, there's going to be some problems with that. You won't be able to do that. But you know what I'm saying? Be reasonable. This is if you can't travel overseas or interstate to get more sun. You know, if you're in Canada and you can't make it down to Mexico, or if you're in Australia and you can't, you know, go to Thailand, or you can't go to Indonesia, or you can't go to, Western Australia or something like that and just bask in the sun. Don't burn yourself. Speak to your doctor first, okay? This is what you do, but ideally you would go and take a holiday or something like that. But if you can't because of financial or family or business or reasons or health reasons, don't be like, oh my God, what am I going to do? Just follow the steps I'm giving you now, okay? So apply it. Remember, we need sunlight twice as much as we need food to feed the electrons, okay? Hope you like this video. That's what you do.